Yeah, it was great talking to you. All right, yeah, I'll see you then. Bye. I don't know about you, but I use my cell phone every single day. I wonder what natural resources were used to make this phone, and where do these materials come from? Phones are made from materials like copper, aluminum, lithium, cobalt, and even gold. These are all natural minerals. Think back to what you know about the geosphere. Where do you think these minerals are found? They're found in rock formations and underground. To access these minerals, we have to mine for them. By the end of this video, you'll know why mining is essential, but also why it comes with challenges. You'll also explore what happens to mining sites once the resources have all been extracted or removed. Are you ready to dig in? Mining is the process of removing valuable materials from below Earth's surface. Minerals are mined for different purposes. Some, like iron ore, copper, nickel, and zinc, are essential for industrial use. Others, such as gold, silver, and gemstones, are valued as precious metals and minerals. And some mined resources, including coal and lithium, serve as energy sources for powering vehicles and factories. Mining is a major global industry that boosts economies, creates jobs, and provides materials for modern technology. Some countries, like Australia and China, depend on income from mining. Why do you think the mining industry is bigger in some countries than others? Mining is only profitable if there are minerals to be found. Imagine someone tells you there's buried treasure in your backyard, but they're not sure where. You could start digging up the whole yard, but that would take weeks of work and a lot of tools and would make a huge mess. Now, what if they tell you that the treasure is actually just one small coin? Would it be worth all that effort? Probably not. In mining, it's only worth digging in areas with large deposits of a mineral. Miners aren't just digging into rocks. They're looking for ore deposits. Ore is a type of rock that contains metals or minerals to mine. Some rocks may have small amounts of mineral deposits, but there has to be a large amount of valuable materials to justify the work that goes into mining to extract, or remove, those resources. In other words, the effort has to be worth the potential reward. Depending on a lot of geological factors, some areas simply have more ore deposits than others. But how do we actually get these valuable materials out of the rocks? Let's explore some of the different mining methods. Some minerals are near the surface, while others require digging deep underground. Different methods are used depending on where the ore deposits are. Let's take a closer look at some of these methods and their impacts. Surface mining removes rock or soil to access shallow materials. There are two main types of surface mining. Open pit mining digs deep, large pits, while strip mining removes soil in layers across the land. In other words, open pit mining digs down, while strip mining digs across the land. These surface mining methods are less expensive, but leave behind large scars on the landscape once mining is done. In other cases, ore deposits are so deep underground that it would take way too long to remove all the rock layers to get to the valuable materials. Underground mining is when miners blast shafts or tunnels into the rock to access resources deep underground. This method is complex and expensive. It isn't as visible from the surface, but it can still change the landscape. When tunnels are dug out, the ground around them can shift. This dangerous shifting is called subsidence, and it can even cause mining tunnels to collapse. Each method of mining has trade-offs, but no matter how we access these resources, mining can have major economic benefits. If there's a big enough deposit of ore to make mining worth the cost, it can help boost the economy by creating jobs and bringing in money when valuable resources are found. But these economic benefits only last as long as the resources do. Mining towns thrive when a resource is valuable, but can collapse when resources run out and mines shut down. These are called boom and bust cycles, and the bust can have devastating effects on communities. Mining can also have big environmental impacts. What kinds of environmental impacts do you think could happen as a result of mining? Pause the video here to record your predictions. All mining methods change the landscape, destroying habitats for local wildlife. Digging into rock also loosens the soil, causing erosion. Mining tailings are the waste material left over after extracting minerals from ore. They are made up of finely ground rock, water, heavy metals, and chemicals. These tailings can run off into nearby waterways in a process called acid mine drainage. The dust and emissions from mining can also contribute to air pollution and climate change. There are also social impacts to consider. Mining is dangerous work. Underground miners can be hurt when tunnels cave in, trapping them underground. And miners of all methods face the risk of toxic exposure. Nearby communities can also be exposed to harmful substances, especially from surface mining. These risks make miners some of the most essential stakeholders in these decisions. Some mines rely on dangerous or unfair labor practices, especially in developing countries. Worker exploitation can be a huge cost of mining, so it's important to have fair working conditions. Despite these risks, though, mining is essential for human life. We depend on mined resources for building, technology, and energy, but these resources don't last forever. So, what happens when the ore runs out? Take a look at this abandoned copper mine. Once a valuable source of copper, it's now a leftover pit that ran out of ore. But the copper mining left chemical and physical damage to the land. Should mining companies be required to restore the land after they extract resources? Why or why not? Pause the video here to record your thoughts. Reclamation is the process of restoring mined land to a safe and usable state once mining is complete. In the United States, mining companies are legally required to restore mined land through reclamation. The Surface Mining Control and Reclamation Act of 1977 and the Surface Mining and Reclamation Act of 1975 are laws that aim to reduce environmental damage and restore mined lands. This involves both restoring land and water resources from old or abandoned mines and regulating active mines to monitor for environmental impacts. Reclamation takes time, money, and effort, though, and not all companies follow through. And though mining laws protect ecosystems, they can increase the costs of mining and reduce profits. Let's take a closer look at our abandoned copper mine. This area used to be a forest, but the mining process changed the landscape drastically. Do you think it's possible for trees to grow back on this soil? Often in mining, the land can never be perfectly restored to its original state. Notice that reclamation only has to restore the land to a usable state, not the state it was in before mining. This means that mined areas can be converted for other uses. What could this land be used for after mining is over? Pause the video here and record your thoughts. Reclamation can take mined land and restore it for agriculture, recreation and wildlife, or residential and commercial use. Sometimes open pits are even filled in to make lakes. Mining reclamation is an essential step in sustainable mining. Even if mined areas can't be restored to their original form, they can still be used in new ways to help support humans and wildlife. As we went through the lesson today, we learned about mining, the natural resources it gives us, the costs and benefits of mining methods, and the responsibility to care for the land once the mine closes. We rely on mined resources every single day, but it's important to extract ore in ways that are safe for ecosystems and the people around mines. In your lesson activities, you'll have the chance to learn more about the resources in your cell phone, and you'll even have a chance to try out mining reclamation for yourself. It looks like I'm getting another call. I'd better take this. Until next time, remember, keep digging for answers because every resource we pull from the earth comes at a cost. By staying informed and making sustainable choices, we can mine smarter, waste less, and protect the land for future generations. See you next time! Hey, hey.